يا ليت الدمع ما ينزل، يا ليت الدنيا تصفى لي، تعبت اشيل واتحمل.
روميو جوليت ليلى مجنون. Now I swear by Allah, there was no Romeo who loved his Juliet more than Abu Bakr loved the Prophet. There was no mother who loved her child more than Abu Bakr loved the Prophet. This is no exaggeration. When they were in the cave, and Abu Bakr said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, allow me to go in the cave myself." And Abu Bakr went into the cave, and there were a number of holes there. And he tore his garment into pieces, and he stuck them in the hole. And there was one hole left. And the Prophet entered. He entered. And then he lay on the thigh of Abu Bakr and he went to sleep. And there was one hole remained. And Abu Bakr thrusted his foot in front of it. And there was a snake in that hole. And it bit the foot of Abu Bakr. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, can you imagine the excruciating pain? And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu took the pain. Why? Because he didn't want to disturb the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He didn't want to disturb the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Until finally, a tear came out of his eye, and it fell upon the cheek of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam woke up, and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, I didn't want to disturb you. I could take the pain, but I couldn't control my tears." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took his saliva and he put it over the foot of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and it was as though that Abu Bakr had never been bit by a snake. See mothers, what do? When their child urinates, they will put the child on the other place and they will sleep on the urine itself. But which mother who is bitten by a snake will not even want to disturb her child? And this is why, wallahi, no mother loved her child like Abu Bakr loved the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Men who were strong for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, men who loved the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know, and this is one of the unfortunate realities of today. You know, we love everybody else besides the people that we should be loving. We love everybody else. We love the film stars. We love Bollywood. We love Hollywood. But people that we should love, we don't love them. And Abu Bakr loved the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And let me tell you what the love of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu did for Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. That Abu Bakr, when he passed away, before he was about to pass away, he asked Aisha radiallahu anhu, "What day did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pass away?" And she said Monday. And he asked her, "What day is it today?" And she said, "It is Sunday." And he said, "I'm optimistic that I will die tomorrow." And then Monday came, he asked Aisha radiallahu anhu, "What day is it today?" And she said, "It is Monday." And then he asked her, "What day did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam pass away?" And she said, "He died just before noon." And he said, "I am optimistic that I will die at the same time." And Aisha radiallahu anha mentioned that he died exactly the same time the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. This is a tawfiq that Allah gave him because of his love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is a tawfiq that Allah gave him. He died the same time. And where did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam die? He died lying upon the chest of Aisha radiallahu anha. And where did Abu Bakr die? He died upon the same place. And where was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu buried? He was buried next to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a narration, "Me, Abu Bakr and Umar are made from one thing, seen in Wahid, from one source of dust, from one soil." And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that from the soil that a person is taken from, this is where he is buried. He's buried from the same soil that he's taken from. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the place between my rawdah and my pulpit is rawdatun min riyadh al-jannah. It's a piece of jannah. If Abu Bakr, Umar and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were taken from the same soil and they went back to the same soil, and that soil from the rawdah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the member of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is from Jannah, then this means that Abu Bakr, Umar and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were created from the soil of Jannah. They were created from the soil of Jannah. And this is the honor that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu had in this dunya. And let me tell you the honor that he had in the hereafter. The Prophet ﷺ said, the first person who will be raised from his grave on the day of judgment will be myself, and then Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And the Prophet ﷺ said, whoever I have done a favor upon, I have repaid that favor. Whoever did me a favor, I have repaid that favor. Besides the favor of Abu Bakr, for Abu Bakr, Allah will repay that favor on the day of judgment. Allah will repay that favor on the day of judgment. And then the Prophet ﷺ said that the first person for whom the scales will be erected for on the day of judgment will be Umar ibn Khattab. And the Sahaba knew the virtues of Abu Bakr, and they said, what about Abu Bakr? And the Prophet ﷺ said, for the likes of Abu Bakr, there are no scales. And let me tell you, if there was a scale, what would have been the case? The Prophet ﷺ said, لَوُزِنَ إِمَانُ أَبِي بَكْرٍ بِإِمَانِ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ لَرَجَهَ بِي. If the iman of the entirety of humanity was placed in one side of the scale, and just the iman of Abu Bakr was placed in the other side of the scale, the iman of Abu Bakr would be heavier than the entirety of humanity. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, the first person who will come to me on the Hawd al-Kawthar will be Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And then the Prophet ﷺ said that Abu Bakr will be my companion on the Hawd like he was my companion in the cave. And then when you move on to Jannah, the Prophet ﷺ said that on the day of judgment, those who fasted, they will be those who prayed, there will be a door which will call those who pray profusely, and they will say, enter me. And then there will be those who did jihad, and there will be a door which will call the people of jihad, and they will enter from it. And then there will be another door for those who gave sadaqah, and that door of sadaqah will call them. And then there will be another door, the door of Rayyan, which will call the people who were fasting. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, O Messenger of Allah, will there be any person that all the doors of Jannah will call? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, Abu Bakr, wa anta huwa. And he said, yes, Abu Bakr, and you are that person that all the doors of Jannah will call. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on another occasion, he said that last night Jibreel grabbed my hand and he entered me into Jannah. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, O Messenger of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, only if I was with you, I could have seen Jannah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Abu Bakr, glad tidings, for from my ummah, you will be the first one to enter into Jannah. And then after this, let me tell you, the greatest virtue for Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, really, is this. The Prophet ﷺ told Abu Bakr that, Abu Bakr, you have attained Ridwan al-Akbar. And there were a group of people asked, O Messenger of Allah, what is Ridwan al-Akbar? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when Abu Bakr will enter into Jannah, يَتَجَلَّ اللَّهُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَامَّةِ وَيَتَجَلَّ لِأَبِي بَكْرَ خَاصَّةِ. That on the day of judgment, when the believers will go into Jannah, Allah will ask them, is there anything else that you desire for? And they will say, no Allah, you have made our fire's faces glow. You have given us Jannah. You have saved us from fire. What else could we want for? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will unveil himself, and he will come in front of the believers. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that this will be more beloved to the believers than Jannah itself. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on that day, يَتَجَلَّ اللَّهُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَامَّةِ وَيَتَجَلَّ لِأَبِي بَكْرَ خَاصَّةِ. That on that day, Allah will come out for humanity once, and then he will go back again. And then the second time, Rabbul Alameen will come out solely for the sake of Abu Bakr. Why? Because this was a man who the deen could not be decreased in front of it.